Live from the CBS Broadcast Center in Philadelphia, this is CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
You guys have anything to say?
Mr. Gargan,
you want to say anything?
Silent, in surrender, Amtrak engineer Brandon Bastian turns himself in, facing charges in the deadly 2015 train derailment in Philadelphia. Tonight, families of the victims have plenty to say about the arrest. Good evening, everyone. I'm Yuki Washington.
I'm Jessica Dean. Eyewitness News reporter Joe Holden is live at Central Detectives, where he's been tracking this story all day. Joe.
Jess, Yuki, attorneys say place questions of intent aside. They claim that is not needed to prove in a court of law that Brandon Bastian was responsible for the deaths of 8 people and that he allegedly created a catastrophe. These are the faces of the victims of the Amtrak 188 railroad disaster, among them Rachel Jacobs, a wife and mother. Attorney Tom Kline represents the Jacobs family and talked with us about her distraught father.
He had just come back from the 2-year anniversary gravesite visit to his daughter's grave, and he wept at his daughter's grave.
Kline then shared the news about a day that almost never came. Families had been holding out hope that 188 engineer Brandon Bastian would face charges in the deadly disaster. The Philadelphia DA's office refused. The Attorney General of Pennsylvania stepped in. Today, Brandon Bastian was arrested outside Philadelphia Central Detectives, slapped with a pair of handcuffs, and brought in on charges of involuntary manslaughter and causing a catastrophe. Bastian was behind the controls as 188 entered a sharp curve in Port Richmond, rocketed to a speed of 106 miles per hour, double the limit. Attorneys say Bastian must answer for why, and the jury should determine the consequences after 8 were killed and 200 injured.
Accelerating and then consciously slamming on the brakes, decelerating, was anything other than risking a catastrophe, reckless endangerment of lives, and yes, involuntary manslaughter.
And our sources tell us that Brandon Bastian is still awaiting arraignment on all of those charges. It is unclear, though, once arraigned, if he will be able to make bail. That is the latest. Reporting live in Spring Garden, I'm Joe Holden, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Thank you, Joe.